the third place decider is about to happen. But before that, we're going to go into a quick interview, or maybe not so quick. We have Rice once more helping us out with the translation. And of course, we have Don Regu, who just qualified in an insane ZVZ against Nesty. So first of all, oh God, my throat. What's happening now? It's all part of the show. Don't worry, guys. Actually, Life was supposed to sit here, but we don't need his insights, so we just talk with you, Don Regu. That match has just been an insane back and forth, and it really looked super, super close in mostly the last game. What do you think turned the tide? Where did you get the feeling that you have it?
재료 형이랑 게임할 때 1-2였을 때 끝판에서 계속 왔다 갔다 했잖아, 그냥 했는데 너가 언제 지금 내가 이겼다고 생각했어?
그러니까 제가 하이브 태클 타고 무리군지 뽑을 준비를 하는데 제덕이 형이 바퀴 히드라로 한번 왔었어요, 제 진영으로. 그거 딱 맞고 나는 순간 내가 많이 유리한 것 같다라고 그때부터 계속 생각하고 있었어요. 네.
Actually, when Donner was taking to Scythe, Nesty he tried to push once with his hard rattling roaches, and when he defended it, he was like, okay, now I should have a big advantage, and from there on, he was pretty confident that he's gonna win.
All right. So if we look at the start of each of those games, it very much looked. I'm not sure if it was in all five games, but it looked like you guys have been all going for the 10 pool or at least very early pools. Is that the new thing in ZVC? As it used to not quite be like that.
풀을 지금 요즘 ZVC에서 풀을 빨리 치는 거 더 좋은 것 같아. 그냥
좋다기보다 그냥 다전제에서 섞어야 되는 것 중에 전략 중에 하나인데 그냥. 이번에 서로 그냥 계속 고집을 부린 것 같아요. 네. 고집 부려서 그냥 계속 네, 그런 걸 계속 했던 것 같아요.
All right. And we now have Life joining us, our second finalist here, who happily comes from a quick break as he deserved since he has to get ready for the finals. But before I said, we have the third game coming up anytime soon. The third game, the third place decider. Oh, yeah. Right, you didn't. Okay, I was confused by the interruption.
About the early pool thing, he said it's like one of the it's one of the birds that you normally use. It's, I mean, it's not like a thing that you do, but he thinks that it just went that way, like that each of them did the early pool, but like, it wasn't intentional. Like nothing to do with the.
It just happened.
It just happened. Yeah.
All right, that's good to know. So let's talk a bit about the game we're about to see. It's going to be Nesty against Marine King. It's one of the matches a lot of people would have wanted to see and now get to see, as there has been some rivalry going on. When everyone is talking about rivalry, and probably none of them had a word with the players itself to have a word with that. Do you guys know anything about a rivalry going on between them? Do you ever like? Are they friendly with each other, or are they giving each other evil looks?
종훈이랑 재덕이 형 라이벌이 뭐 그런 거 있어?
아니요, 처음 듣는데.
Actually, we heard the first time about the rivalry between both of them.
Really, because all the casters keep mentioning it, like, oh, it's gonna be the game because they have like this thing going on. Okay. So I was just wondering if there is actually a thing, or if just someone decided to make that up. So nah, good to know there is apparently no rivalry going on at all.
I mean, Marine King is so much younger than. Nesty, almost 11 years younger than him.
I was like, so Nesty like is 30 or
30. He would turn 31 this year.
Oh, okay.
So he's 30 right now, yeah. In Korean age is even older. I mean, he's born 82. Marine King is born 93. So, I mean, rivalry. I mean, they never met that often. I mean, Nesty랑 종훈이 언제 만났지? 그 GSL에서 한번 결승에서
결승
한번 만나고 아닌가?
모르겠어요. 바로 많이 만나진 않았던 것 같은데.
They didn't meet that often. They met in the GSL finals where Nesty won. And besides that, actually no one of them can remember any.
Oh, that's very good. So I'm learning things. That's great. So who would you pick as the favorite there? As that is the standard question to ask.
제대로 형이 이겼으면 좋겠어요. 그냥 이겼으면 좋겠어요.
저는 솔직히 상관없는데 누가 이기는지.
Okay. Don Regu said he wishes that Nesty is gonna win and Life he doesn't care.
That's also an answer, nothing for us. So I guess you're gonna care about the finals itself. I just gonna assume you want to win. How are the odds? Do you feel confident going up against Don Rigu? Have you practiced specifically in CVC since you knew that there are gonna be 3/3 in this tournament?
솔직히 조금 힘들 것 같고.
아까 무대 위 인터뷰 나온 거네.
아, 힘들 것 같아.
He thinks it's gonna be tough.
That's all he said. Like, yeah. You guys just laughing your butts off.
Suo said, like, you should be honest, but he says, no, it's gonna be just tough against him.
Okay, Last okay. Minute. What would be Don Rigu's answer?
아, 저도 되게 힘들 것 같아. 아, 저도 똑같이 힘들 것 같아.
You think it's gonna be the same for him? It's gonna be tough for him as well.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Are you guys doing that on purpose? Like, do you have some kind of practice going on in mannered answers? Like, there's hardly any taunting. Why? Why? Don't you guys flame each other at least? Try for the interview.
매너가 좋은지 그냥 대답할 때 왜 매너가 좋은지 그냥 사실 그냥 진심으로 말하라고 그냥
안 좋은데 안 좋은데.
아, 저 사실대로 말하면, 아, 뭐 제가 막 자신감 있어하면 좀 열받아 좀 불타올라서 막 경기를 올라갈까봐 최대한 잠잠하게 이렇게 만들어 놓는 거예요.
Okay. Think Don Rigu says it's like better to keep it calm and like man up because otherwise if
you're gonna lose it,
if he's gonna say that he's gonna win for sure and it's gonna be easy and stuff, then life might get angry and pissed and turn to a Super Saiyan or something.
It's just scared. I don't know what this look means, but well, I guess I'm running out of weird and awkward questions to ask you guys, so I'm just gonna let you get back to your booth practicing a little bit. Of course, good luck for both of you for the finals. It's gonna be amazing to watch, so I'm really looking forward to that. And we're gonna throw it over to the casters with the third game decider, place decider, whatever.
It's time to find out who is getting third place here at the Iron Squid Grand Finals.
Exactly.
Beautiful intro. That is my opening statement. That is what we are about to find out. I am Wolf. With me is Kaldor.
And my favorite unit in Heart of the Swamp is definitely the Wiper. Okay. Let's get back to business. We have Marine King versus ST before Wolf starts to explode next to me and Kalaris is not having another laughing fit.
Kalaris is probably downstairs crying right now. It's all your fault.
He actually cried.
Yeah, he actually cried. You could see like long tears as if he had lost a longtime lover or something like this. Like I was afraid he was going to start sobbing as well, but...
Well, we have a lot of fun here at Iron Squid, but of course it's also about the StarCraft 2 matches, and this is one of the games that a lot of people have been anticipating. These two guys met at the second season of GSL, and back in the days, we had like a 7-game series that went to the last match. It was pretty incredible. So right now we have them again here at Iron Squid fighting for third place.
Yeah, this is going to be awesome. You know, it was discussed in the interview a little bit, some sort of rivalry, whether it exists or not. In this case, I feel like it's just history. There's history here. It's one of the most amazing finals. My favorite finals of all time, Marine King versus NST. We have this awesome opportunity to cast this. It's a third place match, a pretty big difference in prize money. I believe 2,000 euros in difference. That's a lot of money on the line here.
Grand Lagoon is going to be our first map, and back in the days, we had NST win the entire tournament. He won the season with a 4-3 against Marine King. So right now, we have the game, the first game going to start really, really soon. And so far, I feel like NST was so close to actually advancing into the finals. He brought it into the last game against DIG.
Yeah, we saw
it was
the game.
Really close.
You and I were watching the entire series from the audience, except for the final game, which we watched here, of course, on our little steampunk couch over there, where weird things happen. But in the final game, the upgrades made such a big difference. You know, with the +3 Carapace coming out on those Broodlords with no more upgrades for the Infested Terrans anymore on Wings of Liberty, obviously the Infested Terrans did not do as much damage as NST wanted them to do.
And we had a really, really strong game played by both of them, but in the end, DIG took it, so now NST suddenly finds himself in this game against Marine King. And if you just think about the last match that Marine King played against Zerg, which was, of course, a semi-final against Live, we had Marine King with a very, very strong game on Daybreak, sick micro.
Yeah.
But in the other games, Live just demolished him. I mean, Live is looking so, so strong, especially in the ZVT. So now Marine King has another Zerg opponent, more experienced, a lot older, and I feel a lot, he's a lot more cunning.
Yeah.
But still, I feel that this is an opponent where Marine King has a lot better chances than when he was facing
Exactly. Life. This is I don't want to say that Life is on an entirely different level, but it's like, he's just more dominant right now. He's in his prime, whereas NST is coming back into his prime, I feel like, but he's not quite on top of his game.
And how cool is that, by the way? I mean, that he's really coming back.
He is really coming back.
When he dropped out of Code A, I was actually thinking, well, maybe we'll see him as a coach.
Yeah, maybe he will become a coach, maybe he'll retire.
Yep.
But he has shown that no matter how tired he is, he will keep going.
And he's not only coming back into Code A, so he went all the way back into Code A. So we now have him here at Iron Squid playing the bronze match. He wanted to go to the final, but in the end, just him defeating players like Parting on his way. Because guys, always remember, this is only the finals. This is the offline finals. We have 4 games in total, but there was an entire season played online already. And if you missed that, then definitely go to ironsquid.tv and check out those VODs that were amazing, amazing games. And some really surprising matches as well. So definitely check out the VODs. They're so worth it. But now we're focusing on the bronze match. We want to find out who takes third place and who's going to take fourth here. We have another ZBT. We have Marine King up against NST. And the players are ready. The game is loading.
I'm ready. And the map, of course, as mentioned before, is Grand Lagoon for game number one in this series to find out who is going to take that third place, that bronze medal, and who's going to go home fourth, last of the last here.
I actually don't even know who the French audience is cheering for the most. NST is such a huge fan favorite here. It's really difficult to describe, but if you are sitting in the theater and you have these massive chants. I actually think that on Reddit there was a YouTube video that was linked earlier. If you haven't seen it just yet, check it out. I think that was when NST was entering the stage. It was really, really impressive. But Marine King, he appeared in the audience. I mean, he sat down at the front and suddenly people from everywhere were rushing in and were just trying to get autographs and trying to get pictures. So both of them, like, being huge fan favorites here in France, and I'm not quite sure which one is the favorite for the French audience.
Yeah, it's really hard to say. They're both quite heavily favored by the fans. Marine King is a Terran player, first of all, in this tournament, and is one who stands out alone as the Terran. So that's really something to consider as well. Really, really excited going to the series. Just makes me think back to those finals so long ago. Marine King back then using the tag Boxer and being called by his fans at that time Foxer. Decided to call himself Marine King because of his splitting that everyone talked about.
And that splitting, we've seen it in action today.
We have, man. Marine King almost clawed his way back into the finals with some pretty clutch play, of course, earlier against Life.
Big problem just for him that the fourth map was Abyssal City. This is always a map where you're very uncomfortable as a Terran player against the Zerg. And for Marine King, there was just no chance of getting back. He fought hard.